going on, folks? Been a while, eh? It's a diesel wrench four coming at you. I'm not sure how long it's been, but it's been a while, and I owed you guys something. So, here we go. Be short and sweet, because it's actually going to be a review. I was looking for something to get back into doing videos, because I haven't really had the drive to do them. So, a while back, I was talking with John from Sutliff Tobacco via email. And he sent me some stuff to sample and make a video. So that's what we're going to do. It's not going to be an in-depth review. He wanted something short and simple. So that's what you're going to get. So today, we're going to do a little video about a review. As we just spoke, it's not going to be an expert critic. Oh, and by the way, you guys have probably never seen this one. It's my freaking, I can't remember, 1970s era church warden. It smokes pretty good. I don't smoke it that often. I just wanted to try the church warden. I see you guys all rocking them out, so I said I got to have me one of those. And the product that I have stuffed in it today is, this is an arrow. Yeah, I'm doing my arrow pipe. It's April Dawn by Sutliff. It is a aromatic blend of sweet cherries applied to a base of Virginia and Burley. It's basically, you can't see the pretty colors in there because we rocked it old school with some black and white, but it's a nice ribbon cut. Old Virginia's in there. So, pretty heavily cased as most Sutliff arrows are. But it's alright. I haven't been doing much smoking of aromatics. So, it's alright. The Burley comes through on it, which I like. But again, there is the casing is pretty heavy on it. It's not like, what was last year's toss around when they were giving the samples and everybody didn't like it, but Rachel Turtle Ray 8 did. What the heck was it? What is it? Name of like some kind of sailboat or something. But it was super, super, smelled like maraschino cherries, but it tasted like soap to me. I can't remember what it was called, but that was a Sutliff cherry as well. But this one's good. It's kind of a, like a mild candy cherry flavor. I wouldn't say like Jolly Rancher cherry, but it's nice. It's not, you know, the heavy casing isn't overly, it's not overly cased. We'll go there. But it's all right. It's not something I wouldn't buy it, no offense, John, but that's just mainly because I haven't been into the arrows. But it's a pleasant smoke. I haven't got much for bite out of it, but then again, that's probably the warden doing his job. I imagine in a short pipe and in a hot smoke, you would you'd probably fry your tongue pretty quick with it. The moisture level's good right out of the tin. It was good, packed and lit. I relit once because I was talking. I'll probably have to again. But if you were smoking this pipe, I would imagine it would, the moisture's good. I don't know. I don't really do reviews, but I got to learn them, right, from my boy. So, yeah, I mean, we'll get back to the tobacco. We'll just stop and see how everybody's doing. My life's took a turn again. You guys are probably sick of hearing that shit. We're not going to go there. But things are all right. Things are all right. Doing well. Enjoying. Been smoking a lot of, getting more into the cigars. You know, trying, branching out. I haven't really bought any new pipes. I've been going crazy on corn cobs for some reason. But, you get that. Feel bad, I haven't really been in contact with many of you. So, again, I got with John, we're gonna kick my channel in the butt and get it back up and rolling. Get out there. I'd like to get some time to talk to some of you folks again and see, watch your videos. I miss everybody, you know. So, that's that. That's me. You got anybody, guys, gals, that smokes Wardens? You guys like to clench these things? Yeah, clench them? You're like, look, Ma, no hands with this long-ass pipe. I try, because I'm a clencher. You guys know, watch my videos. I love to clench. Do you just... Nah. Church Warden's non-conducive to clenching, for shame. Well, you can do it. It has a good flavor. It has a good flavor. I mean, you get it even without... You don't have to retrohale to get the flavor on this one. Which I find I do with a lot of arrows. Actually, see, I get more of the burley when I retrohale with this one, which is strange for me. I don't know. But, it's a good smoke. It's for you arrow smokers. I mean, anybody that's into non-aromatics probably wouldn't be a real big fan. But I came into it with an open palate, I guess, an open mind, and it's enjoyable. I mean, I'll smoke it. Unless anybody wants to try it, let me know. I'll send you some. John was nice enough to send it to me, so, yeah, there it is. There's plenty to... Ooh, we spilled a little. Plenty to go around. I haven't had the joys of sending a package out to anybody in a while. I've got a few. I got to send some out. But, yeah, so anybody wants to try some April Dawn? Let me know. And then maybe if I send you some, you could do a review on it. And we'll see where you stand. And we'll let John know to check that out as well. So we'll get a couple people checking it out. Where are we at? 7 minutes, almost eight. I don't want to take too much time. You know, usually I come back because I don't make a video and then I sit there for 20 minutes or a half hour and drive you guys nuts and girls. But, April Dawn by Sutliff Tobacco. It's not bad. It's, first I said it was a candy. It's mellowed. It's not the candy sweetness. It's a semi-sweet cherry now. Huh? Yeah. Like a $3 lighter on eBay. Look how small it is. Tiny. Had to try it, though. You guys all got them fancy lighters. So. So, yeah, some new. Back to arrows a little bit. This is, you know, that's being new. Trying to arrow. Church Warden, new. Review, new. Joined a gym recently, new. Making changes. Become a new me. I see what Nick, the Polish Piper, the transformation that boy's made. That'll give you some motivation. Thank you, brother. I appreciate that. I gotta do something, so. Well, I won't keep you guys. If you're an arrow smoker and you like cherry, try it. Yeah, try it. If you're an arrow smoker and you're not big on cherry, still try it because you like arrows. Especially if you like a burley that you can taste through. non-aero smoker, don't bother. Don't bother at all. Ronnie, now in Colorado, the cherry you like is Hobbitweed. No comparison. So don't switch it. Not that you would. I'm just throwing it out there. Yeah. Short and sweet. But it's good. It's a good tobacco. It's a good quality. You know, Sutliff's a good quality product. And I would say that whether or not I was doing a review for them or I wasn't. So, it's good. Just not for me. Appreciate you guys tuning in. I hope all is well in life. And that you're all enjoying yourselves. Summer's about over. Kids go back to school in a few days. So, before you know it, I'll be standing with snow in the background. I'm not looking forward to that, but I am looking forward to the leaves are changing. They've already started. You guys can't really, well, obviously you can't see, but we'll get you some of that. All right, thanks for tuning in. It's a Diesel Wrench 4. Keep them wrenches turning.
And the pipes and the cigars burning.